In this lesson, we are going to take a look at the creation of work planes in Autodesk Inventor. You'll find the plane tool here in the work features panel on the 3D model tab. I can click the drop down next to it, and I have the plane tool, but then we'll look at each specific ones first. So I have offset from plane. The way this one works is you can click and drag on a plane to create an offset plane. So let's say I wanted one an inch away from the existing surface. I can type in one and click the checkbox, and I've now got a work plane that I can sketch on 1 inch away from that part. The next one we're going to look at is parallel to a plane through a point. So let's say that we're wanting to create a plane at the top of this pyramid. I'm going to choose this option and I'll click the bottom of the pyramid to be parallel to that, and then the top point to now create a plane that is parallel to the bottom running through that top point. The next option we'll look at is midplane between two planes. With this one, you just simply select two parallel planes and it will construct a plane in between those two surfaces. As with all other features, this is completely parametric, so if the extrusion depth were to change, that plane will continue to be in the middle of that part. The next one we'll look at is angle to plane around an edge. So this is a handy tool when you want to create a feature that's at an angle to another surface. You simply pick a plane that you want to angle off of and an edge that's going to act as the center of the rotation. Then you can type in a value. So as you can see, if I put in 30, it's going down into the part. So I'm going to want to adjust this particular one to negative 30 to get it to go up. Then when I finish, you can see we've now got an angled work plane that I can then sketch on to create a feature that perhaps extrudes into the other feature. The next option we'll look at is going through three points. So I can select any three points, and Inventor will construct a plane that goes through those points. The next option we'll look at is through two coplanar edges. So I can select any two coplanar edges, and Inventor will construct a plane that runs through those. Next, we'll look at some options that deal with curved faces. Tangent to a surface through an edge. So in this example, I can create a plane tangent to this cylindrical surface running through an edge of the part there. So there you can see tangent to the cylinder and then running through a specific edge. Next, I want to create a work plane that is tangent to the top circular shape here, and it's parallel to either the bottom or one of these top faces here. So I'll choose tangent to a surface and parallel to a plane. So once again, I'll select a cylindrical surface and then a plane that I want to be parallel to. And now you can see it constructed that tangent plane. The last method that we'll look at is normal to a curve at a point. This one is really handy when you're doing swept features. Here I have a path and I need to create a sketched shape at the endpoints of one of these two curves. I can choose this last option, normal to a curve at a point. Select the curve and then its endpoint, and it will now construct a work plane that is normal to or perpendicular to that endpoint. That will then allow me to sketch in my profile shape to sweep along the path. Now, as with the work axis and work points tool, you do not have to choose the specific ones. You can choose just the plane tool, and then it will construct a plane based upon your inputs. So I'll do the same thing on the opposite end here. I'll choose the curve and the endpoint, and you can see it constructed that specific one, even though I didn't choose that specific dropdown. That concludes this lesson on work planes in Autodesk Inventor.